Nah, that's pretty
All
good.
right, this is part two. And like the game, my computer actually caps out at 3 hours.
Oh my
so,
god.
Kronos was attacked by the Romulans, taken,
Robert,
and
yes.
then the Klingons took it back, but in their bloodlust zeal, they literally bombed their own planet. So they've retaken their home world, but
the people
it's,
who
stayed on Kronos
were traitors anyway. They were horizontal collaborators, so we bombed them.
My god.
Can, you give me ascendancy token, please? So I'm at 4 ascendancy.
Jeez. So I am also at 4 ascendancy. So would you mind someone giving me ascendancy token? Thank you.
Yep.
And then 2 for that. Thank you. And then how many ships we got? We are building.
Do you have a production node? Not that I need it, but I just want to make the planet more difficult to conquer. And I'm going to run out of ships anyway.
Yep.
Okay. Alright, we have research. I'm sorry, I could just go ahead and. Oh. And then.
I'm out of ships.
I will be killing them.
Okay, so.
Oh, where's the Ferengi thing? Did you use it last time?
I'm using it this turn.
Oh, okay.
He gave it to me. He used it last round.
Yeah. I'm upgrading my weapons.
Okay, so I'm going to have the science fleet. Let's see. Yeah, port 2.
You're not attacking him, I take it.
No. He'll be.
Are you not attacking him?
I'm not attacking him, no. The only way I'm going to win is that if I discover a few places. Or I bid like crazy to go. Well, actually, I think the victory check
is
at the end.
Done at the beginning of the recharge phase before you collect resources.
Okay.
I thought you could ascend at any time.
Yeah, well, you can, but the victory check is
before. Right, before you collect resources. So nothing we get this turn in resources is going to help you win this turn. Help you win in the victory phase next turn.
Okay.
Do we all collect stuff?
At the same time.
At the same time. Okay.
All right, so I'm actually going to drop this guy out of warp at the Eagle.
Your shield's plus 2?
Yep.
Okay, so you collect that science token.
Yep. And I'm put that on the Cloaked Orbital Mines research. And then, let's see.
Do we have warp tokens? Everybody in warp last time?
Yeah, I don't have anybody in warp. I am warpless.
You? Everybody's out of warp.
Warpless.
Yeah. I got the only fleet in warp.
So how did the movement work? Like, could these all go together, or?
There's separate commands to move them, but once they were in position to attack, then it's one command to attack.
So you
two
can
big fleets and two single ships.
Okay, I see.
Yeah. All right, so I'm going to use my second command to move my maxed out battle fleet. It'll take two commands to get to the Argolis cluster.
Mm-hmm.
You just need one more culture place too after that.
Say again?
You'll need one more culture place after that too.
Yep. Yeesh, yeesh, yeesh. So, I've got 9.
Yep. And I plus 1 on my shields. So,
you need 3. Is that for... Oh, yeah. And then you have a station as well.
Right, but you have first strike.
Yes.
Oh, do you have first strike on space or
on the space station?
What does it say?
First strike on...
You're not attacking the space station.
I'm not. I'm attacking the ground because there's no state. There's no stuff. So it's just normal attack.
Where is the attack going?
Attacking the undefended our goal.
It's got to start. It's got a base thing.
Yeah.
Right.
So yeah, he rolls 4, 5 back.
4, 5, 6.
Okay. So and it's 3 or higher is a hit, right?
Yeah. Well, hold on. What is your attack?
My attack is put 2+.
It's 2, and I have 1 shield, so it hits on 3s.
Yeah. So 3 or higher I hit. So
maybe
6.
Are you sure? Oh, you built all the way up to 2.
Yeah, he spent a lot on weapons. Okay, so you have 6. More than enough, right?
Yeah, more 6. Than enough, so okay, everything will stay.
Okay, so I just have a counterattack. I need to hit on I hit on 4s, but you have a shield bonus that puts it up to 6, right?
Correct.
Okay, so
you roll
6.
Give him 4.
Sorry, my bad.
6. Why 6 die?
4 plus this one.
Oh yeah.
No,
he's right.
The stations I thought was only. I think it was. Yeah, stations only for space battle, unless there's like an upgrade for it. But you roll 5 back though.
Okay.
So I don't roll for the space station.
No, that was that's for space battle.
It's a bonus. It's a bonus for space
battle. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh my gosh, 6 6s. No, 2.
All right, so 2 ships.
2 ships
are gone. That's fine with me.
I was gonna say, that's fleet 1.
Oh, yeah.
That's your science fleet.
Did they get swapped?
Yeah, just swap them back.
My bad.
Yep.
No, because this is the science fleet, because that was one that was at warp.
Yep.
Sorry about that. Okay.
Came in pretending to be a science fleet.
Yeah, right.
So
he needs to get 1 more culture so he can generate 5 culture on the build phase.
Yes.
And get enough for ascendancy next turn.
All right, so I'm going to spend another command.
I saw that after I decided not to bid for a first.
So I need another command. So 2 commands to get to, what is it, Capella?
Capella.
Okay. This is where we got to...
You could take it back in your turn, though, right?
Yeah.
Conceive.
Okay, now, yeah. But this is where I'm going to use his trick. So I'm spending 2 for this guy to get here.
On
but then I'm going to spend 1...
You could spend 1 just warp him in.
No, he's
warp and then
he's getting the adjacent one to it's what
Oh, but you're right. I could spend 1
spend
to
1 to move him.
No,
one.
No. You gotta warp in and out, it's 2.
Because otherwise,
oh, because you gotta
spots.
Spend another. You
yeah.
gotta spend another to bring him out of.
Yeah,
he's right. He's right.
Okay.
So this is fine. And then, okay, so we've got.
Don't trust a Romulan.
So we've got 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Mm-hmm. All right. We got
so it's first strike against the so you're attacking the spaceships.
Yes.
Okay.
And I have first strike on the spaceship, so
yep.
All right, so
did you already spend that command to attack?
Now I have.
Okay.
So that'll leave me 1 yes, and that'll leave me 1 to attack the planet, mm-hmm. correct. Alright, cool. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna roll 9 and then I'll roll 2 for the wait. I lost count already. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Okay,
Dave. So 9, and then roll.
I'm just seeing what. Yeah,
shields
are like. Did the science.
You got 1 better shield than your weapons.
No.
Okay.
No.
So they're all the same.
People have the
same.
There is a tiebreaker. I think it may be.
Number of systems control.
So 3 or higher.
Yep.
Fuck yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's all of them, right? Because I have 5 ships.
Yep.
Okay. So 5 hits. My counterattack. Still, I hit on 6s.
Yeah.
That's nothing.
But where is how's first strike?
Oh yeah.
First strike, yeah.
So they're all dead.
Yeah,
that's right.
Jeez, Romulans.
All right, and I'm going to spend my last command to attack the planet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so. Oops. Hopefully I think I'm over. Yeah, I'm over. So
okay.
there's no need to roll again.
Well,
so,
I get to blow up to my ship.
But you get to blow up on my ship, right?
4
dice.
So,
yep.
4. There you go. No hits.
Okay.
All right.
So Romulus has has declawed the Klingons.
So I'm next.
Yes.
See, now I'm thinking to keep up with you guys, I need to take Bajor. Because let's see what this science fleet finds. Because I may...
take one more picture.
I don't want these. All right, good. Discovery. That gives me a culture. Ha ha.
Much easier than attacking Bajor.
Oh, and the discovery is to take another culture. Holy cow. I get one for finding a discovery. All right, I'm not going to attack Bajor. I'm just going to explore the galaxy.
Who's going to attack you?
Oh, yeah. No, because I was going to reconstitute this into a second fleet at 1, 2, 3.
See, because you can get for exploring, there's no reason for you not to explore.
Yeah, no, I'm gonna do it now, especially since I just got two from one planet.
So you have one more and you're done, right? One more culture.
One more culture, yeah.
And then he's so it's one more round, and he's
no, no. He can spend the ascendancy as soon as he gets it.
Yeah.
And then at the beginning of the maintenance phase.
Yeah.
It won't matter who controls what.
As long as I have my home planet.
Yeah.
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 Okay.
Because you have to have the home planet to get victory on anything.
Yeah.
Right? So, ooh.
That's a clever little trick you did, and I got to remember that.
What? Like exploring?
Don't explore out of your home planet, but one time. So his home planet's at the end of a very long chain. The only guy who acted was a Ferengi, and he's on it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, not with my... My weapons are pretty good.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Kind of the same thing what you're doing. Different from what you did, because you did
my home world's two jumps away from Bajor.
All right, I'm going to have this ship.
Yeah, we need to move the aggressive powers in and put the Ferengi in the Federation.
In the middle? Yeah, that's probably a better way to do it.
Sweet!
That's a good point, because otherwise it was just going to be the two aggressive powers duking it out, and then neither of us are in a good position.
Crisis. Level 4 hazard. If any ships survive, you may immediately build a colony in the system for free. So, but I've upgraded shield, so it needs to be a 6.
Science fleet?
No, it's just 1, so. Yay, culture. Oh, and that's a dead end planet.
Interesting. Crap, yes, 8 more commands.
Yeah, those upgrades have helped me. I'm going to go ahead and... Actually, I should have been using... I'll use another one. I'll put this fleet in the warp. So it'll be... I can move 3, 1, 2, 3, and then I'll leave from there. Where's the die? I'm looking out. Can you,
how convenient.
I draw two. Damn it, why am I not getting phenomenon?
We're capable.
Sweet! I discovered a civilization.
Ah, that's game.
That's game. Wow.
All right, and then my other movements will be one ship here, one ship here, one ship there.
Explore and win, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Well, that's then, what Starfleet and Federation should be doing.
Yeah.
Yep. Cool.
I was trying to sneak into a backdoor purchase. I had Ascendancy 1. I had another 25 per round.
You're the dominant culture across the galaxy, but look at all my gold press.
So you can buy an ascendancy from somebody?
Five per culture.
Five of those
you can buy a culture chip per 5 production.
So he needs 25 production.
He was just stockpiling.
Well, it. I was
but
now.
But the crazy thing was, is like our production was almost the same because I have all these trade agreements and
plus,
this planet.
And I was out of commands. But the next thing I was going to do, I was going to turn off one of your trade agreements.
Yeah.
I was gonna turn off the
You should turn off the Ferengi one. Look how much money he's making.
Oh, that's true. I should have turned off the Ferengi trade agreement.
That's one, two, three, four. Yeah.
That's a good point.
Had you not been able to do that, let's say you kept just kept going places.
I would have attacked Grace Major.
But you were starting to use up your market retail.
I was running out of ships.
Right.
No.
Why? If you spread your ships out, what are you gonna? How many ships are you gonna bring?
No, but you couldn't get back to me.
I was gonna retake Bajor and take a couple other places because every successful invasion I do gives me a culture.
So
I was gonna hammer all the weak worlds and attack them.
Oh, you were waiting for everybody to be weak, and then
I was waiting
just
for people
burst.
To need systems with not much in.
Didn't happen actually, because especially my plants, like this.
No. What's
these
going
are
your
fortress.
Oh, so going your way.
He's waiting for us to exhaust our forces
fight,
and then steamroll us.
I'm like, I thought if I could take.
But your warp level is still warp 1.
Unfortunately, that's something
See,
I didn't
for
not...
me, that saved my bacon because I'm like, I'm jumping in and out of warp. I'm going 3 each time. For you, that helped too.
I can see
you have to work on that as a player. You need to have deep strike capability.
I got really lucky with this one because it gave me 2 culture just for landing on it.
Now, if you're not at war, can you send multiple fleets through? And then attack, which then, of course...
Well, if I see what you're sending a bunch of ships towards my home base, I would just, like, you're not allowed...
Right, can you do that?
Yeah.
If you have a trade agreement?
Whenever you go... No, you would just say you're not allowed to warp past my ships anymore. You become a rival. You may lose the trade agreement, but if you're like, I want to send 9 ships into Earth, I'm like, no.
So you can stop it even if you have a peace agreement.
Right, yeah. Because essentially, you're always like in the. Every time you go through someone, you're always tacitly agreeing to move. Because you can have a trade agreement and not allow them to warp through you.
So theoretically.
This was a close game.
This was a close.
That was fun.
The Klingons were going to win until the Romulans took them out and they weakened each other. The Klingons were going to win because you had 4. I, at the time, only had 3.
And then...
Well, I was hoping to build a 5th culture over here.
Yeah.
And
I kicked myself a little science here when I really didn't need it. I should have built some culture.
Yeah.
That's actually, I had an open... Yeah, this one here, I should have built that as culture also. That was... Yeah.
This thing here, every culture count is an extra production for me.
Yeah.
I kicked myself to build that extra science.
Oh, yeah, that was...
But you have to leave a ship. You have to leave a ship.
Yeah,
it took a command to get a ship there.
Game.
I can't believe you never used your hunter killer fleet.
What does that do?
Automatic hits.
The problem with a big multiplayer game like this is you saw what happened because I wasn't connected very well with them and he wasn't going to fight them. That made it easy for them 2 to fight. But if you and I fought, the Klingons could have come in on me like a fat rat.
Yeah.
It is hard to fight a war with one guy and hold another guy off.
Yeah, it really is. So next time we do this, we definitely need to put the Romulans, whoever plays them, the Romulans and the Klingons need to be on opposite ends of the board, and then the Beast will be in the middle.
But that's canon. Like, the Klingons and the Romulans hate each other.
I think you should just randomize it.
It would be random and also be ideal if we did have a 5-pointed table or something like that.
a bigger table.
Well, and then that when the new expansion comes out, I need to get a 7-sided table.
Yeah.
So 7.
We can try to do a 4-player game next time when I get my map.
Okay.
Because they're evenly spaced. There's like a lot of space in between.
I definitely want to play with the Borg next time.
Okay. So let's do that. We have like 4 players and then the Borg.
Yeah,
that would probably.
Can you get assimilated and join the board?
Yeah, no, that's what happens if you
take over your turn.
If your civilization gets taken over, the Borg have a turn, and you do a turn as the Borg.
Like a zombie player.
So the Borg gets 2 turns if they take over, and if they take over a second player, they get 3 turns per round.
Oh my goodness!
Yeah.
Oh jeez.
The Borg essentially become unstoppable.
Maybe I'll just like automatically assimilate with the Borg.
just to
screw with everybody.
The Borg expansion, I'm curious to try.
Yeah.
And what happens is like the Borg have a a random.
Jen, watch out.
Oh, like, sorry. What you do is you draw a card, and it's like warp two systems to the nearest star base, or the largest fleet, or the nearest homeworld. So the Borg are kind of sporadic of where they would go.
Yeah.
But once they start closing in on someone's homeworld,
it's nasty.
Yeah.
I like this. I wish I'd gotten that sooner. Oh,
I didn't get this.
It's here for the longest time.
Yeah.
But,
I'm going to park my Overseer fleet over that and have A production.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about your Overseer fleet.
I like all my...
I never had a place that had two production.
I might try the Cardassians next time. They're
fun.
They look a lot more versatile than I originally thought they were.
I actually like the Ferengi.
The Ferengi are cool.
As long as you don't get attacked.
Yeah.
That's why you make yourself indispensable by like...
Think about the Ferengis. They can build a pretty big fleet.
Oh, geez, yeah.
They're trying to build up so much production.
Yeah.
Well, their battle groups aren't that big. They're lost... I think it's only like 7 ships.
Even on the backside?
Yeah.
Yeah, but they can spread out.
Yeah, 7.
Yeah, they can spread out really
10.
Quick.
10, yeah.
But... Somebody, I thought somebody had 12.
No, the Klingons had the largest one.
I do like.
Yeah, I thought everybody did. So I started looking.
I like how sneaky the Romulans can be, but I definitely will probably try the Cardassians next time.
I like the Federation, man.
I know you do.
We're a dealer, just
keep stealing everybody's. Nice plans. Just keep exploring.
Well, what was great was the Federation needs to be powerful in order to bully trade agreements in cooperation.
Yeah.
Like, I'm so friendly, it's threatening. Like, it's just like I have
kind of how the United States rolls, actually.
Yeah.
Because it's the same thing.
That was interesting. I was literally... Oh, I had gone through the thing.
What?
That's why I was out of Phenomenon.
Oh, we went through the whole deck?
We went through all the Phenomenon?
There was one left.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I got like 2 or 3 of them right at the onset.
I think the game needs a little diplomacy.
Yeah. Because like,
we're kind of informally doing it.
Yeah.
Like,
there's no mechanics.
Oh, but like
something
more than a trade agreement.
Well, there's a trade agreement, but you can't say, like, I'll give you 5 production if you don't attack my
game. You know what? Almost no game lets you do that.
Yeah.
Huh.
We can always write that in.
There's a handful of games that I played, a couple I worked on at Avalanche, that allowed, like our Soldier Kings game about 7 years ago.
Hmm.
You could actually say, I want, you know, Quebec and the Ohio River Valley, and you give
right.
me 3, you know, resources a turn for 10 turns. You had to write them down.
A friend of mine played with a Axis and Allies mod that somebody had built,
mm-hmm.
and they like cast miniatures and everything for it. So they added like, you know, V2 rockets and landing craft and some other random shit. But it also added a mechanic for special political deals. Like they were kind of limited. Well, there was a couple of political deals and then special abilities
for
bags for
ships and stuff.
Yeah, this was
so
essentially
like
all these bags.
So like for example,
bags.
Both the Germans and the Russians could do a non-aggression treaty, to where the Russians and the Germans couldn't fight each other in the Axis and Allies game.
That big game I was telling you about, where I played the one after the British.
Yeah.
That had a companion game made for Colorado.
Oh,
Days
cool.
of Decision.
Decision.
You could actually play the companion game as World War II. Instead of building units, you build army points and navy points.
Okay.
But it had very detailed and subtle, had a map.
Yeah.
It had communism, fascism, and democracy.
Uh-huh.
And it had hexes, and you started countries out on different hexes, and you could try to draw them into your orbit.
Oh, interesting.
And it was that was a lot of fun. And, you know, if you're the Germans, your goal might be to say, get the Poles.
Right,
to join
right.
Germany and not have to fight them.
Right. Interesting.
I've seen Russian players quit when that happened. That's it, you know.
They're like, oh, that's it, I'm done.
Start over. Oh, there's turn order cards.
That's what we've been on,
but we were doing it.
We were able to remember it.
Yeah, we were able to remember it.
That's where those old short short my
all these little bags in the middle. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, there's
got to be a good size bag because
I put in two bags.
Yeah,
there's one
for the ships, one for like the bases.
Why do they have two bags?
Because they deserve it. They need something to rebuild their home world. Blasted to pieces.
Got it.
I think we need bigger bags for these.
Where's the ascendancy bag? I have all these ascendancy to turn in.
Toot your own horn there.
I definitely got lucky with the discovery that just like.
Oh, they gave you the extra.
Yeah, that, yeah, it's like, oh, you know, you're the Federation. You're going to get a culture just for discovering it, yeah. And the award for discovering it is culture.
Yeah.
Do you have a bag for the. Man, I'll just. One. They were like
that's
larger. Fine. They were there were bags over there for the space lanes.
Yeah.
Now how do you keep those? Oh, okay. So the Cardassians have their own box.
Well, what I usually do is I put all the like things.
That was fun. How do you like
these?
That was fun.
Yeah.
That's good.
Like,
it's yours, sir. Cheers.
I got everything.
Yeah,
I
appreciate the invite, guys.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun.
I don't have the Cardassian expansion
expansion.
But I probably will get the board expansion.
Are you guys
all
on Facebook? The Facebook?
Yeah.
Or Nova or whatever?
Yeah, Nova Fleet.
So how do you guys
know? One.
How does who?
Nova Fleet is how I met everybody.
Yeah, through Star Wars Armada.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't need the. You can just borrow the Borg expansion. Like, you don't need to spend. Like, if you just.
I appreciate that.
Yeah,
no,
it's
that's
like.
He wants his own map.
I guess so.
Well, I saw the map was released, like, recently.
Mm-hmm.
So I asked those. I asked.
Well, it's not big.
I asked the games to have him order it for me because I, like, ooh, perfect. It has little slots for where you put all your cards and, like, has pre starting positions. I'm like, ooh, lovely. Shannon wasn't too thrilled. She was like, you have 5 maps already. What do you need another one for?
Nice. See, that luckily this 6-1 works well. Like this 6x3.
Oh yeah.
Well, the fact that also you could it's where the vinyl works for us.
So much,
yeah.
You're getting so much mileage at it, and now that it's so like flat. Like
yeah.
The vinyl actually does work a lot better.
For this game.
For this
game.
Because you want stuff to be able to move around a little bit.
Yeah.
Where's the 3 lanes?
Over here.
Okay.
Is there another Ferengi trade agreement somewhere?
It's probably
it's probably
all your Ferengi stuff goes in there.
Oh, just everything.
Except
there?
For the plastic
here's
pieces.
Your,
they go in their own bag.
Oh,
yeah, the dials and your ships. Go ahead and put those two things.
Do you want these in here too then?
No, I've been putting those in
Okay. What about those star bases?
Star bases go ahead and like put in with the upgrades.
Okay.
I put mine.
I think I dumped my upgrades in here.
Well, thank you all for such an awesome game.
Yeah.
This was actually faster than I expected.
Yeah, no, same here, because I told the girlfriend.
I told
that
it would be until 8.
Yeah.
Awesome.
See, you said 1 hour per player?
1 hour per player.
Yeah. It was about that.
I could see the Borg maybe, but actually,
the
Borg may speed it up. It would probably
because you don't have time to research a whole lot of technology or go for ascendancy at that point. Just like everybody, throw ships at it, kill it.
Yeah, because the longer what stinks is that the Borg. What happens with them is you mix, there's Borg discovery cards mixed in. So one of them could be like you go to a planet, there's a
Borg cube comes
right. There's a Borg cube there. And some of them are good where it's like a crashed Borg, like essentially the Next Generation episode where it's a damaged, like
Borg
isolated Borg or a Borg scout ship, so you have a chance to kill it. But I forget at what point you mix in those cards, but essentially you don't want to go anywhere without a battle fleet cruising around because if you accidentally come across the Borg,
like with one ship, then
with one ship, then you're done for.
Wow.
So, Right. If well, you guys want any more stew before
you go. Are you guys going to do something this coming Friday?
Not this Friday, Friday after.
Friday after. Okay, yeah. Just send me a, send me a message to remind me.
Yep.
Yeah.
No, no, not
Jody and I are going into the city for the weekend. So.
Oh, cool.
Anything in particular? Is there an event?
There's a soccer game on Saturday night, and then there's this fundraising event for not for Parkinson's disease, but it's connected to that. It's Sunday morning, and there
okay.
One's at Audi Field, one's at Nat Park, a block from each other. So we just got a hotel for the weekend instead of going back and forth.
Nice. So, yeah. Okay.
Hotel in Southwest?
Yeah, we stay at the Hampton Inn.
Okay.
That's a good way to do it.
Yeah.
Cool. We went to the Hazy earlier.
Nice to meet you. Yeah.
I love that place.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, man.
Thanks for hosting. Hey.
Where do you live?
Oakton.
Okay.
I live,
Well, we live down in Legato, over by Fairfield County Government Center.
Okay.
Yeah. I live back Miller Heights, Miller Road. I live in Windsor.
I just said some estate sales out that way this morning.
It's interesting.
Not dying yet.
I didn't realize how important the bid. At first, I thought the bidding was like no big deal. It was like near end.
No,
game.
Near the end of the game, it's really important.
Yeah, I was gonna bid everything I had. If you didn't get your Ascensi, I was gonna bid everything I had that wasn't Ascensi points to get that.
Yeah.
Cool.
Thanks, Christian.
Thanks for the game.
By the way, that stew is delicious.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, it was the best rabbit I've ever had.